the fast and easy way to spot an investment scam. It is always disheartening whenever there is news of a new scam and you hear of the stories of the hundreds of thousands of Filipinos who lose their hard-earned money. But at the same time, it is frustrating. Bakit may nagpapaloko pa rin? To help with this, here is a quick video on how you can spot an investment scam. And it's actually just 5 words. These 5 words are guaranteed returns in ridiculous rates. These are 2 concepts that one needs to understand. So let's quickly discuss each one. Number 1, guaranteed returns. First of all, every investment guarantee is only as good as its guarantor, yung nagbibigay ng guarantee. So if you spot some company or person promising you 10% returns per month, even if they say it's guaranteed, that guarantee is only as good as that person's word and their ability to make good on that promise. So you'll have to ask the question, how can they promise that kind of return? Now, the most reliable guarantor of money in the Philippines is the Philippine government. Why? Because the government can print money. On our money, it literally says, ang salaping ito ay bayarin ng Bangko Sentral ng Pilipinas at pinanagutan ng Republika ng Pilipinas. That means that the Philippine government is guaranteeing that our money, the Philippine peso, will have value. So, in terms of investment guarantees, the government has the strongest one. Again, because of the fact they can literally print more money to make good on their promises. Now, next on the list of strong investment guarantees would be coming from the conglomerates and large businesses. For instance, you can trust PLDT, Jollibee, Ayala Corporation, and other giants to make good on their investment promises because they literally have businesses all over the country earning money. So when they promise you a 5% per year return or 10% per year return, that becomes possible because they can consistently get cash flow from their businesses nationwide and even internationally. If we move on to smaller companies, the guarantees become less and less reliable. And the weakest type of guarantee is actually that one coming from regular individuals. And now that you understand how guarantees are not created equal, let's go to the next point. Number 2, ridiculous returns. To understand what ridiculous is, let's first establish what is reasonable. There's a common saying, if it's too good to be true, chances are it's a scam. But with a lack of financial education, many people don't know what is good and what is too good. So let's elaborate on that. Going back to the example of government investments, when the government offers investments, they do so in the form of treasury bills or T-bills for short. Basically, this is the government borrowing money from the people and in exchange promises a return. So whatever rate the government is offering on their T-bills, that is the safest return you can get at any point in time. Now, this rate changes over time with the economy. You can just go to Google and type in Treasury Bill Rates Philippines and click on the link to bsp.gov.ph. And you will see the historical 364-day T-bill rates ranging from 1.9% per year in 2012 to record lows of less than 1% in 2013 to now as high as 6% this 2019. So this is on the low end of what is reasonable. Let's go to the high-end reasonable rates of return by going to the stock market. If we look back at the stock market returns over the last few decades, the highest returns would have been 90% and 67% annual return. But these were super rare cases. That 81% return happened in 1999 during the recovery of the economy from the Asian financial crisis. And the 67% return happened in 2009 after the subprime mortgage crisis. So these are rare events. And on average, if we look at the average, the stock market only gives a return of 12% per year. So this is the high range of investment returns. Now to emphasize, the rates we are talking about now are all per year annual returns. And what's reasonable is anywhere from 1% all the way to 12%. And the higher you go, the rates become more unbelievable and ridiculous. So if we look at one of the biggest scams, like the Kappa Ministry, they promised a 30% per month return for life for a one-time investment. 30% per month times 12 months, that's a 360% return. How crazy is that? If we look at other scams, Aman Futures, they promised 80% return in 20 days. What? And the lesser known scams like the Royal Manchester or the Tibayan Group and the Telecom Investors Corporation, these companies promised as little as 3 to 5% per month. But when you convert those returns annually, 3% per month becomes 36% per year. And 5% per month, while seemingly small, that's actually 60% per year. It's still too high to be reasonable. They are ridiculous rates. So let's summarize. How can you tell if something is a scam if it gives guaranteed returns at ridiculous rates? What is ridiculous? Anywhere above 15% per year guaranteed, you should start becoming more skeptical. And the higher you go to 20%, 30%, 50%, and beyond that's still guaranteed, my goodness, that's already ridiculous. Stay away from it. Do not let greed get the better of you. Don't believe it, even if other people you know have made money. Don't be a fool and don't let others fool you. When you see an investment promising ridiculous rates of return, follow the advice of Scar to Simba. Run away. Run away and never return. The fastest way to become rich is often the slow but sure path. That path requires more discipline, skill, patience, and persistence, and of course, proper financial education. Hey there! J3 here, and I have a question for you. Have you ever wondered how ordinary Filipinos like you and me can achieve long-lasting wealth? Like, honestly, hindi yung pinanganak na mayaman na o hindi kailangan manalo sa loto. Well, I've thought about that question for a long time. In fact, I've been studying it for more than 10 years already. And I'm excited to share with you what I have discovered. So, there are actually just 5 rules that you need to know in order to achieve wealth. Follow these 5 rules and you will gain wealth. But if you ignore these rules, you'll end up with financial struggle and poverty. Now, I want to share with you this training, and I put it in an online seminar called The 5 Rules of Wealth. And I truly believe that this training is what every Filipino should have been taught in school. Hindi naman tayo tinuruan tungkol sa pera sa school, di ba? Now, this is the reason why I've made this training for free. Just go to pinoymoneyacademy.com/5RW, sign up, and start learning. Hope to see you there!